deeper dive into the 2018 LS. One thing I just wanted to say before I start is the journey's been quite interesting because in September of 89, actually, it was in the Lexus dealer in a showroom, and actually was selling the LS, the first generation LS. So five generations later, here I am getting to talk about the car once again. Different clientele, but it's definitely an interesting thing to think about for me. So without further ado, we're going to walk through the LS. So again, the LS 500 and the LS 500H are two offerings. The LS 500H is not available with an F-Sport package. You can get F-Sport on the LS 500, so the gas variant. Driving performance, again, with this new platform, it was critical to make this car fun to drive. Over the years, our president, Akio Toyoda, has really wanted the Lexus products to inspire and elevate the experience of the driver. Not just be a luxurious vehicle, but also something that kind of brings some life and fun to the drive experience. So with that, Asahi-san and his engineering team, they developed this all-new twin-turbo V6 engine. It's V35A FTS is the name of it. It produces 416 horsepower and 442 pound-feet of torque with a pretty flat torque curve at 1600 all the way to 4800 RPM. It's using our dual variable valve timing with intelligence, and actually on the intake side, it uses VVT-IE, which is controlled by an electric motor. On the exhaust, it's using a traditional VVT-I, which is hydraulic controlled on that. Pretty impressive miles per gallon, 19 city, 29 highway, and then 23 combined. And then the all-wheel drive is 18 city, 27, and 21 combined. So some of the engine characteristics and key new technologies. At the top are kind of the ones we'll highlight. The high-speed combustion as a result of long stroke. We have high-efficiency intake and exhaust ports. Lexus first, utilizing laser-clad valve seats on the intake. And then multi-hole direct injectors. And you can see a variety of other implementations with the engine to bring this vehicle to life. So the laser-clad intake valve seats, this is a proprietary process done in-house. It was actually pioneered for engines for Formula One, World Rally Championship, and World Endurance Racing Championships. So utilizing a laser with a powdered steel alloy, laying that down, it actually winds up causing a much smaller size valve seat, and as a result, you have a 0.04 inch larger diameter than a pressed-in valve seat, so it increases that capability. It allows for a radical redesign of the port shape as well, and all this contributes to increased airflow into the engine. So one of the things, of course, important is the high combustion with this. So you'll see the valve-clad, laser-cladded valve seats in this animation, just to give you a sense of some of the technology that's gone into this vehicle. So on the left is a traditional. We've increased the intake and exhaust angle, longer stroke, so the engine is under square. So on the left is using the traditional pressed-in seat design. Also to increase port intake, so again, just a better flow to the port. See the laser clad takes up less space there. And all of this results in a high tumble ratio, which allows for great combustion. Side, you'll see the combustion happening. Again, with the it's six-hole direct injectors that are being utilized now in this engine. So it's all said and done with that strong tumble flow. It results in better air-fuel mixture, great combustion, minimizes the energy loss, and has great thermal efficiency for this engine. With the engine, of course, we have our twin turbos for this engine, so it delivers the high driving performance, fuel economy, also to quiet operation, because of course, you know, it is a flagship, so we wanted to make sure that the level of noise was reduced too. So I think we're able to meet all those attributes, and of course, low emissions was a key factor with that. So left-hand side, and I apologize, the pictures aren't probably as robust as we like them, but just to give you an idea of cost, that's a conventional turbine on the left side, so the impeller blade in the turbo itself. So our turbo technology is developed in-house with Lexus, and they looked at that and wound up curving the turbines on the blade of the impeller and actually increased the length of the blade. The idea with that is it allowed for a better use of the gases inside the turbine and just allowed for a better efficiency coming out of the turbos themselves. You see, with this angle, it actually winds up increasing the gas use into those turbines and gives us that great efficiency we have for the turbos. Another thing, we're using actual electric actuated valve for the wastegate. So again, the valve's opening and closing precisely under high loads, and then that gives us increased acceleration. But it's also, the valve is opened under light loads to reduce the pumping loss to contribute to reduced fuel usage. So again, we're trying to get power out of it, but we also want to make sure that we're not losing any efficiency in the process. So for those of you who've been around with our Lexus, we have a D4S with our engines. In this case now, it is D4ST, which is direct injection, four-stroke gasoline engine, superior version with turbo, it's a mouthful. But the goal with that was to have a high level of compatibility between a high tumble ratio and then a boost control. And again, result is enhanced fuel economy at low speed torque. 10-speed automatic transmission, direct shift. It's the first in a premium passenger car. With its closely spaced gears, it allows for more rhythmic acceleration. Also, too, there's a newly developed torque converter, lockup, and then AI shift control. And what this is now doing is, it's looking at the driver's intention, and it actually, the vehicle speed and acceleration is paid into it. And in the past, the only way that really came to life was either in Sport or Sport Plus mode, that it could do that. Now it actually can happen in just normal mode with the transmission. So it helps kind of figure out what the driver is intending to do and brings that to life. So the LS500H is utilizing an all-new direct-injected 3.5-liter V6 and, of course, our lithium-ion battery pack in this vehicle. The battery pack is reduced in size. In the back, still it sits. The 8GRFXS engine produces 295 horsepower with a total system output of 354 watts. The very impressive fuel economy numbers, 25 city, 33 highway, and 28 combined. And that's for the rear drive, and then all-wheel drive is 23, 31, and 26 combined. So with the our traditional hybrids, we're using the planetary sets, MG1, MG2, and with that, we've made it a four-speed automatic transmission, basically, to that. And as a result of that, using each of the gears on the automatic transmission piece, we then tie that into the results from the power split device. So in essence, at that first gear of the automatic, we're able to get three gears with our power split device. Again, the second gear gives us another three. Third gear on the four-speed shift device gives us the final three. And then fourth is automatic mode. So with that, it simulates a 10-speed automatic transmission within the LS500H. The nice thing too is you can actually, for the first time, use manual mode, and it stays a manual mode, so you can actually have some fun while driving this LS500H. Again, the goal was to have rhythmic shifting, so it's not like hybrids of the past where you had that kind of rubber band feel where you felt it waiting for it to wind up and there was just a continuous This actually has in it the shift points in there. So again, giving a fun acceleration and responsiveness to the vehicle. Suspension and chassis. So the global architecture for luxury platform that we spoke about really allowed a lot to be done from a structural standpoint on the vehicle. One of the things, of course, was packaging. You know, wanting to make sure with this low profile to make sure that really brought out the attributes that everyone was looking for with the drive capability. So the center of gravity in this vehicle is relatively low, 540 millimeters. And I can tell you that's just a little bit higher than our Grand Tourer, the LC. So it actually, for LS, to have a coefficient of drag, that means center of gravity, that close to our coupe is a pretty outstanding accomplishment. But the way they were able to do that was, of course, having the low hood line. The hood is actually 1.2 inches lower than the outgoing model. The front tires were moved forward, and then the engine was brought backward, again, trying to keep the heavier components more to the center of the vehicle itself. And the way to think of that, I guess, is, you know, if someone has, like, you see this ice skater, when an ice skater's got their arms out and they're doing that spin, they can get very wobbly, but when they bring their arms in, they have a very tight, you know, center of gravity, and so that way, very controlled and allows for a lot of skill. So also, too, you know, just by moving components in, that helps, but utilizing materials such as aluminum, so the hood, front fenders, side doors, and the rear trunk are also utilizing aluminum, as well as the shock towers as well. And the shock towers, again, it's a steel that they are being put to. So the aluminum, you can't meld it to steel. So we actually are using rivet technology to kind of pierce to get them together. Multi-link front suspension, we're using double ball joints on the upper and lower. And then that helps increase wheel control. And as Sahi-san mentioned, you know, precise steering, that's the goal with this vehicle, to make it fun to drive. All the LSs in the US feature the adaptive variable suspension, so that's standard on all the LSs. Same thing in the rear. The goal that was using the tow control arm was placed on the rear side of the suspension, so it gives, again, stability when cornering. And then the vertical distance between the upper and lower arms is increased and reduced the reaction force, and again, enhanced steering stability when cornering. So adaptive variable suspension. The adaptive variable suspension that we're using now, we've gone to a linear solenoid actuator, so it has 650 levels of damping force. Previously, it was only 9-step, so this one is much more responsive, a continuously variable, if you will, utilizing the G-force, yaw rate sensors, and speed sensors with that. And again, provides a comfortable ride, but also a sporty ride, depending on how you adjust the mode select. There is an available electronically controlled air suspension. So again, that's going to deliver a much nicer ride for those that want that. It's actually, we do have one on the current LS, but this one actually now has a closed system. So the air for elevating the vehicle is actually captured in a cylinder that stays filled. So it's a much more instantaneous result with that. And the reason for that is we have now this access mode setting. So Asahi-san wanted to make sure that our customers, that they, the current customers, the vehicle was at a proper height. You know, we've got this lower to the ground LS, wanted to make sure that we weren't going to alienate or, you know, make those customers unhappy with this new redesign. So the vehicle has the capability of raising. So if in the MID setting, you can control it. If I approach the car, grab the door handle, use the key fob, it'll raise up about 1.2 inches. Then when you get into the car, it'll lower to the normal setting. Go out for a drive, park the car, get out. It's going to raise 10 millimeters, so about 0.4 inches to get out. So again, really trying to cater, and that's part of that human touch, omotenashi, trying to understand and anticipate the needs of the driver. There's also an active stabilizer system available. With that, shows here, it's going to give that suppress the vehicle roll with no deterioration of the ride comfort. It's using a newly developed ECU for this, so it gives finer and smoother stabilization. Also, Lexus dynamic handling system using VGRS and dynamic rear steer with electric power steering. So these are part of a package on the F-Sport. So we have F-Sport, but the regular F-Sport, if you will, that's, you know, the looks of the F-Sport, but this one is a performance package, so it incorporates these attributes. And as a result of that, it actually lets us bring to market our newest VDIM. So it's VDIM, Vehicle Dynamics Integrated Management, Step 6. And what it's doing is, with the Lexus Dynamic Handling, so the VGRS and Active Rear Steering, that is going to help at low speeds with maneuverability. At the mid speeds, it gives enhanced steering. And high speeds, it really, you know, it's like you're on rails at that point. It really kind of gives you great control and confidence. But you add to that the active stabilizer system, and then that's going to give some enhanced ride comfort, but also the enhanced vehicle posture. So anti-roll movements under control, and then also any input from road surfaces will be able to handle that. So when you put that all together, VDIM is the 6 degrees of freedom as it's shown here. So we've got the longitudinal, we've got vertical, we've got lateral, and you can see what the systems employ that. So like lateral is the Lexus dynamic handling, NVSC, vertical to the ABS, adaptive variable suspension. Pitch using ABS, yaw ties in LVH, VSC, which is our vehicle stability control, ABS and traction, and roll with the ABS and the active stabilizer. So again, it's 6 degrees that it's actually controlling the vehicle. So again, enhances the ride quality and confidence inspiring with the vehicle. But as I mentioned, it's a performance package available on the F-Sport. And I don't know if any of the F-Sports that we have here actually have this package on it or not. For the brakes, we have 4-piston, opposed 4-piston front, 2-piston rear calipers. Up front, they're 14-inch ventilated and 13.1 in the rear. F-Sport does have a larger brake. We're using 6-piston up front and then 4-piston at the rear with a 15.7 front ventilated rotor and 14.1 in the rear. It's also a high friction brake pad that we're using on the F-Sports. Run flat tires are standard on all the LSs. There are a variety of wheels that are available, 2 19-inch wheels, 3 20-inch wheels basically. But one of those 20-inch wheels are actually standard on the F-Sport, the F-Sport wheel. It's got a charcoal finish to it. Aerodynamics, of course, you know, that's key to not only for wind noise reduction, quietness, but also stability, increasing the capability of the vehicle. The drag coefficient varies by model, so the spec sheets that are in your press kits, you'll see those for the individual, whether it be an LS500 or the LS500H. Drive mode select, a little bit different. We've introduced this way back when with our LFA. In the past, our majority of our cars had the controller in the center console, so now it is up off of, you know, in the range of the steering wheel. The idea with that is, too, is like it's more centered. We tried to get everything centered around the driver, so there's no change in posture, because if you needed to go to the right and kind of rotate the dial, you've got a bit of a rotation in your upper body. The idea is kind of hands on wheel, just adjust it, and keeping your looking straight ahead. So again, making the car more of a driver influence from that standpoint. So up front, Tsuga-san kind of took us through the look of the vehicle. You know, we have a triple beam LED, they're bi-LEDs. Moonroof, and then there's a panoramic moonroof that is offered. We also feature a hands-free power trunk, that's a standard feature. Key in your person, gentle kick underneath the center of the bumper and remove your foot, and then the trunk will go up. You can also use that same thing for closing the trunk as well. So it's a nice convenience feature. Here's the wheels. So we have a 19-inch, the 219s and this 20 cast alloy, or feature a noise reduction capability. The 20-inch forged alloy wheel is similar to the one that is on our LC500. And then this is the F-Sport wheel. On the inside of the car, we feature a heads-up display. It's the world's largest heads-up display. It's a 24-inch by 6-inch display in color. The nice thing about it, too, is I think we're all somewhat familiar with the heads-up that are out there. This one is pretty far removed. It's about 3 meters out in front of you, so it just kind of is there. It's not distracting. It really seems to be a great integration into the vehicle with a lot of useful information. So on the left, we have basically, in this case, we have navigation running, so it's telling us our next turn, what's coming up. We're using our lane departure alert, lane trace assist feature in this one. We have miles per hour shown, so there's a road sign assist capability, so it'll show posted signs. And then, of course, on the right is miles per hour and the tachometer showing. So just showing some examples, it'll actually project, you know, kind of what the lane trace is doing. If you're having a little lane departure happening, it shows an orange. If need be, if you're coming up on a car, it'll give you an indicator up there for braking. And then parking sensors as well, so if you're getting too close to something. This is kind of an interesting graphic because I don't know what's going on, so I think something is attacking the car. Could be.
Zombies.
Yeah. Yeah. And then, something also too is our front cross traffic alert indicator. So that will let you know if you're at an intersection, if there's a car, it lets you know that there's something coming from that direction. And then also pedestrian alert, a new enhancement to our safety system. Climate control, available four zone climate control. So if it has rear seats controls, you get the four zone. It's now utilizing infrared matrix sensor that picks up 16 locations. The outgoing LS only picked up 6, and that was only for the backseat passengers. Now this is reading all areas of the vehicle. One of the nice things too is you're using the multimedia, the touchpad. You can actually turn on the climate concierge with this, and it's a bit of a set it and forget it. Climate concierge will actually set the, you want it at 65, it'll set the climate. It'll also adjust the heated or ventilated seats to match that temperature desire, and it'll turn on the steering wheel if need be to do that. So again, it really is, it's a concierge taking care of everything for you. Kind of a graphical representation, so if we could have four different zones and you could have the temperature adjusted for each of those individuals with that. Seats, very impressive, available 28-way power adjustable seats, utilizing both motors and pneumatic devices. So for those of you who are familiar, our seat controls on the sides of our seats, that's going to control all the things shown in red, the more traditional features. If you use the touchpad, get into the seat setting and the dynamic display, you can then adjust things like the headrest, the amount of bolstering coming from the upper lower portion, the seat cushion. Another neat thing about the LS, there's a function on here where if you are getting out or getting into the vehicle, this cushion actually lowers ever so slightly, so it kind of makes it easier again for that ingress and egress feature. The massage seats use the air bladders, and there's actually 5 programs. There's 2 full body ones. And basically you get a massage while you are driving or sitting into the vehicle. And there's some that are targeted to maybe just the low back, upper back kind of a thing, and it does for 15 minutes. In the rear, as we did with our outgoing LS, we still offer an executive package with the ottoman. It's a 22-way power seat, features the footrest, and also too this controller here. Allows you to adjust audio features, climate features, a whole bunch of things. And even in a non-executive package with the rear seat option, you'd have power seat options with that center console. And what's interesting is too now, this is, it can actually fold up. It's not quite the same as in the past where it was a fixed unit there. Multimedia, we're using a 12.3-inch nav screen. With that, we have a remote touch interface. It's actually larger now with the more response rate to it. And so you can go in, climate, click on climate. It brings up a submenu of things you can directly go to. Once you choose that, you'll see, the settings. So in this case, if it was climate, you could have clicked on seats in there, and that would bring you to the controls for your heated or ventilated seats in there. Audio sound system, Pioneers, the bass system, 12 speakers. There's also Mark Levinson reference audio system with 23 speakers and 2400 watts. Yesterday, I think we had Levinson in the hospitality booth. So if you haven't checked them out, you'll have an opportunity though again today to do that, because they will be at Skywalker Ranch as well. So in-car demo. And you're standing near the car, you can just hear the sound pouring out of the car with the windows up. So it's quite an impressive sound system. Also too, at Skywalker Ranch, there will be two seats that you can actually try as part of the Ottoman package. They're outside of a vehicle, so you can definitely make use of that. Here's just showing all the speakers where they're at. We even have speakers in the roof area as well, so part of like a 3D sound that is available with this. It's 7.1 channel surround sound, but be sure to engage with Kyle from Mark Levinson, because he can really tell you everything about it. It features also this quantum logic immersion technology that I will let Kyle explain, because he understands it very well, and he really kind of reproduces that music and brings it as close to the real thing as you would expect coming from our flagship vehicle. Also too, we do and have been offering Lexus Inform, our suite of telematics, and so Safety Connect, Service Connect, Remote, and Destinations have been out there. The one big thing now is that Safety and Service Connect is complimentary for the first 10 years. It's transferable too, so if someone's leasing the car for 3 years, they turn it in, that those Safety and Service Connect features are able to be used with the next guest. The big news though for 2018 OS is incorporation of dynamic navigation, Wi-Fi, and App Suite 2.0. App Suite 2.0 allows you to use some apps, iHeartRadio, Pandora. We've added NPR One using that for your phone. But the big news is dynamic navigation, the feature of dynamic map, dynamic route, and dynamic POI search. Again, all nav systems, the data kind of is baked into the car probably about a year prior. We know there's a lot of development going on, especially for those of us who are in the Plano market. There's new developments happening left and right, restaurants, buildings going up. So what it does is it reaches out to the cloud, and the digital command communications module brings that information down to the car and actually overlays it onto the map. So you have real-time mapping, which is pretty impressive. And dynamic voice recognition, much more casual speech. You could say something like, I want to go to the Statue of Liberty in New York, and it does that for you. So it's pretty impressive. Check it out today. All the cars are enabled. And Wi-Fi can do up to 5 devices. Safety is always important with Lexus. So we have Lexus Safety System Plus Standard. We've introduced this a few years ago on other vehicles. So that incorporates our pre-collision system with pedestrian detection, all-speed dynamic radar cruise control, lane departure alert, lane keep assist, and then intelligent high beams. So again, if the oncoming traffic, if you have your high beams on, it'll dim them. As soon as they go away, the lights will go back up to high. But now for the LS, we have the Lexus Safety System Plus Advanced Package. So it kind of takes what Lexus Safety System Plus has and then adds these additional feature set to it. So for the pre-collision system, we also now have pedestrian alert and active steering assist. We'll take a peek at that in a little bit in the video. Lexus CoDrive is the combination of our dynamic radar cruise control and lane trace assist. So lane trace assist is kind of the next evolution of our lane keeping assist, in the sense that once you're using dynamic radar cruise control, it actually can better navigate around turns. So it's a part, it's why it's called CoDrive, because it actually kind of helps guide the vehicle around. It's an impressive feature. If it can't pick up lane markings, it actually has the ability to lock onto the car in front and sort of mirror their movement. Of course, not if they're going kind of in the wrong direction. front cross traffic alert, as I mentioned, and then the roadside assist. So increased sensor capabilities with the Lexus Safety System Plus A, as you can see here, to help kind of do some of these new features. So pre-collision in the current LSS Plus, collision's possible. We have a pedestrian there. It's very likely. So now, so we've got an alarm. We now have pre-collision brake assist. So it's priming the brake so that if you do decide to stop, hopefully you would, it's going to give you extra braking force. If they don't stop, it will, because it detected this pedestrian, apply to the brakes with automatic emergency braking. Lexus Safety System Plus kind of pulls things back as far as we get an alert even sooner. That alert would show up on the heads-up display. Kind of continues the process, but at the end here, if the collision is extremely likely, the vehicle will try to steer around the individual. And what it's looking at is the lane markings, and if it is capable to actually apply some steering input to get around the pedestrian, it will. But in any event, it's going to stop. So it's going to stop, or it's going to navigate around and stop. So it's an impressive system that's added as part of this Lexus Safety System Plus A. So here's a video of that in action.
PCS bases its assessment on information received from the forward-looking millimeter wave radar and a stereo camera system that can detect three-dimensional objects on or near the road ahead. With the addition of its front lateral side radar sensors, the PCS detection area has been expanded to detect vehicles approaching from diagonally in front of the vehicle and support the avoidance of crossing collisions at intersections. If PCS determines that a collision is likely based on the position, speed, and direction of the Lexus and obstacles on or near the road ahead, the Lexus warns the driver with a flashing warning light, an audible alert, a message on the multi-information display, and a warning shown in the head-up display. If the driver applies the brakes, then pre-collision brake assist adds greater braking force in relation to how strongly the brake pedal is depressed. At the same time, the adaptive variable suspension system controls the damping force of the shock absorbers to help maintain an appropriate vehicle posture. If the possibility of a collision increases, the front seat belts are retracted. Pedestrian alert detects a stationary or moving pedestrian in front of the vehicle and draws the driver's attention to the pedestrian with a simple animation in the head-up display. Working with input from the front millimeter wave radar and stereo camera, if the system determines that a collision is possible with a pedestrian on the road or a continuous structure such as a guardrail, it will apply the brakes. If the system judges that the applied brakes alone will be insufficient to avoid the collision and that there is a suitable evasion space within the lane, active steering assist automatically applies steering force to help avoid the possible collision.
And this is our lane tracing assist. So as I said, this is the evolution of lane keep assist. So we'll see how this...
LTA uses the Lexus's stereo camera to recognize white or yellow lane markings. This high-performance camera can even recognize the boundary lines between asphalt and grass, soil, or curb stones. In situations where the lane lines are faded or difficult to detect, or the distance to the vehicle ahead is too short, information from the millimeter wave radar is also used to recognize the path of the vehicle ahead and estimating the path for the Lexus to follow. In addition, when all-speed dynamic radar cruise control is in operation, Lane Trace Assist provides steering control to help keep the Lexus in the center of the lane with minimal swing, even on gentle curves.
Your hand must be on the wheel, of course, with that. It actually uses capacitive sensors in the steering wheel, so it can sense that, you know, this is not intended that someone can take their hands off and let the car drive. All-speed dynamic radar cruise control, as I mentioned, and lane trace assist is the co-drive option. Well, it's not an option, it's part of the advanced safety package. Roadside assist also, as I mentioned before, so in this case, we're seeing the 60 mile per hour speed limit. It'll display speed markings, also stop signs, yield signs, and no entry signs up in the heads-up display. We do have also the panoramic view monitor. So in this case, it's the panoramic view, which is over there, and a side clearance view. So if you're navigating down a narrow roadway, it kind of lets you see how tight the area is and make that drive. And then down below, this is showing one of the images, the panoramic view, but also a cornering view, so you can kind of get a sense of, it shows you where you're turning by the input of your steering wheel to kind of help. In this case, they're trying to get out from, looks like, some curbs there.
Are those guides actually on
the front of the vehicle? Yeah, it's the dynamic, yes. And then we also have our parking support brake, PKSB. That incorporates intuitive parking assist with auto brake. Intelligent clearance sonar is what we're using for that. We have rear cross traffic auto brake. That's using our, we've had the quasi milliwave radar system in the back of our vehicles to let you know that there's people coming behind a car, but now it actually has the capability of applying the brakes for you. And then also a rear pedestrian support rear camera detection. So it actually now, if it sees a pedestrian in the back, it can actually apply the brake too for us. And lastly, we have the pop-up hood for pedestrian detection is incorporated into the LS. There's a lot more that the LS has to offer, but in the interest of time, wanted to kind of, you know, get through some of the real highlights and get you on the road. But for the meantime, it's